Before we start kirtan, I'm going to read a small paragraph. About the holy name, the true nature of the holy name. This is a letter from Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. There's no point in making a separate effort to artificially remember the Lord's form, qualities, and pastimes. The Lord and His name are one and the same. This will be understood clearly when the coverings in your heart are removed. By chanting without offenses, you will personally realize that all perfections come from the Holy Name. I'm going to read it one more time. There's no point in making a separate effort to artificially remember the Lord's form, qualities, and pastimes. The Lord and His name are one and the same. This will be understood clearly when the coverings in your heart are removed. By chanting without offenses, you will personally realize that all perfections come from the Holy Name. So everything is found in the Holy Name, in these three words, Hare Krishna Rama. It's just a matter of deepening our faith and realizing, you know, what has just been read, has just been said by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Kirtan is not a performance. It's all about glorifying Krishna by chanting His names. You know, sincerely, with devotion, with love. And this is not easy, because the mind is, it's Kali Yuga mind, it's a little crazy. So, you know, we need a little discipline when we're trying to do something seriously in everything that we do, materially or spiritually. Especially chanting Hare Krishna. So whenever the mind is running away, it will run away. And especially if we're sitting down for like 2-3 hours in the kirtan, it's going to try and find an easy way out. Either thinking of food, you know, what we're going to eat after, or the bills that we have to pay, or work, or the phone calls that we have to make. But we have to disregard all these when we are in kirtan. Because Krishna and His names are none different. So we're inviting Krishna to come dance on our tongues. So we have to be very careful how we deal with Krishna as a person through His names. So let's try and be conscious of this. You know, let's try and chant every syllable, every mantra, every word, like we really mean it. It's not just, you know, coming into one ear and coming back out through the other one. You know, it's meant, kirtan is meant to create something powerful and wonderful in the heart. And ultimately connect us with the Supreme Lord, Krishna. So please chant loudly. You know, you can sit in your chair. You know, those who are young, you know, please come join us on the floor here. You know, the chairs are meant for older people who have back problems. You know, the younger people, we can come and do some yoga here. Right. But most important is to chant. This is not a spectator sport, you know, where you sit and watch, where you just sit and listen. You do get some benefit when we listen, But we even get more benefit when we chant Krishna's name sincerely. So please chant loudly, please chant with your heart, and please move forward. Wow. Should I repeat that? Please move forward. Please come closer. There's space in front here. You can move in front. We want to sing as one powerful voice. So, you know, for that to happen, we all need to be, you know, on the same wavelength, you know, and as close as possible. So please move forward, you know, let's see. On the other side, move forward a little bit. Can't see the man in the middle. Always shy. Please, Bruce, please move forward. Everyone together, a little louder.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. So, thank you all for coming. January 1st is not over. We have more kirtan until midnight. Please stay as long as you are able.
Arrivo!
Arrivo!